Hi, Jonathan Randazzo here, and today I'm going to be talking about slide technique and articulations through the trombone excerpt La Gazza Ladra. Now with articulations, you can use a wide variety of syllables depending on the range, the speed, etc. Now for La Gazza Ladra, I typically use a two syllable. And not just for La Gazza Ladra, but anything in general that I am going to be wanting a more pointed articulation. I find personally that a ta articulation sort of spreads the tongue out a little too much, and I'm more susceptible to getting a twa articulation. Now, when I say two, if you notice when you say that syllable, it sort of points the tongue in a more direct way, creating a much clearer and crisper articulation, at least for myself. Now, as far as tongue placement, you want to make sure that the tongue is hitting in between the roof of the mouth and the back of the teeth. For upper register notes, you're going to want to change the syllable to more of a T articulation, which will raise the tongue, speed up the air, and make those upper register notes a little easier. Now, last, you want to make sure that you're using enough air behind each of the articulations. I like to think of the air as blowing the tongue out of the way so that we don't focus too much on the articulation, and we couple that with more air, giving our embouchure and our tongue a little bit of an easier time with whatever it is that we're going to be playing. Let's talk about slide technique. For this excerpt in particular, or any time we play anything with high speed, we want to make sure that we keep our arm nice and relaxed and have a lot of wrist action. We never want to stop directly on a position. We want to tongue the notes as we're passing and moving the slide. The reason for this is if we stop at every position, what happens is we get a little bounce. With that bounce, it's going to create extra tension and instability in our sound. Now, as far as style goes for La Gazza Ladra, we want to make sure that the longer notes are nice and buoyant and we are not playing them completely even and straight across. After a while, that can start to sound boring. Now, in an audition situation, I want to make sure that I am very, very conscious of the other music that's happening, not just in the excerpt, but in the rest of the orchestra. So in order to set that up, I might sing a little bit of the orchestra part in my head. For example, the second excerpt of La Gazza Ladra, I might sing just to help get inside the music. Lastly, we want to make sure that our phrases have a nice arc to them and that we're always leading to the bottom of the line. If we play things too straight across and too even, like I said before, it will start to get very boring very quickly, and you want to make sure in an audition situation that you separate yourself from the others, because there's going to be a lot of players that go there that can play very, very well. And the best way to do that is through your expression and through your music. So today we've talked about articulations, slide technique, and style for La Gazza Ladra. Let's see if we combine all of that, what that sounds like and looks like on the trombone. Thank you. Well, thank you for watching. I hope that you found this video informative. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel below, and I hope to see you online in our Zoom sessions, and if not, in Santa Fe, maybe next year. Take care.